Hello everyone, this is Lincoln, the channel for Higher Self. Welcome to the Satsang with the Self. In these videos, I channel the Higher Self for you. The Higher Self is a state of intelligence, awareness, and energy. It's our greater self. During our human experience, we often identify ourselves as being the body, as being the thoughts in our brain and the story that the thoughts tell us. In truth, we are not the physical body, and we are not our thoughts, and we are not the character in the story. We are truly a state of eternal consciousness. We exist as an open space of awareness. That awareness has a silent intelligence, and that awareness is filled with the creative power. We exist as this higher self state, and we're projecting ourselves into this human experience. In every moment, we're exploring ourselves as the creators of our own personal realities, as our consciousness interacts with form. The purpose of these channel higher self videos is to help you to awaken yourself as this eternal creator so that you can most fully experience your human life. When we realize that we are more than our body and more than our thoughts, we free ourselves in remarkable ways. We can learn to exist from this state of spiritual freedom and express ourselves in ways that bring great happiness to our own life and lives to the people around us. In these videos, I expand my consciousness into this higher self state and I communicate with you. Often I don't know the topic of the video I'll be presenting. I just simply channel and allow the communication to flow. For tonight's video, I don't know the topic, but I'll let myself channel the information that serves this moment and serves you best. I hope that you enjoy today's channeling. Dear One, close your eyes. Feel the center of your chest. Feel your heart. Be at peace. You, dear one, are life. In every moment, you are shining yourself as awareness, intelligence, and energy. Feel yourself as this radiant space. Feel yourself as the expanded emptiness. As you feel yourself as the space of awareness, notice the peace, notice the stillness. In every moment, dear one, you shine as stillness. In every moment, you shine as a perfect state of peace. Notice these qualities. Embrace these qualities. In today's teaching, dear one, we are going to help you to establish yourself deeper in the state of peace. Now, as you know, there are many different methods and practices and teachings around the establishment of peace. There are different practices at controlling your thoughts and different practices at controlling your breath or the movement of your body, but we are going to teach you something different. Understand, dear one, that as long as you are trying to use personal effort from the feeling in your head, then you are still continuing to act as the personal self. There's nothing wrong with acting as the personal self, But if you desire to know more of what you are beyond this thought-based experience, then we do recommend you follow our guidance. First, dear ones, relax. Relax into the feeling of your body. By feeling your body, you bring your awareness down from your head and extend your awareness throughout the human vehicle. Understand, dear ones, that you have nerves, you have energy centers, you have chakras and meridians and nadis, all spread throughout your human being. Essentially, your form-based intelligence fills your entire human structure. We as souls can experience a greater reality when we expand our consciousness more fully into our human vehicle. So the first thing we do is we relax. By relaxing, the charge of electricity that carries our consciousness into the head balances itself and spreads throughout the body. When we relax, we release the tension that sends nervous system charge up to the brain. You see, any time you're tensing or contracting a muscle, it's sending an impulse up to the brain. When you tense your body, your brain gets a lot of energy, and that makes your brain excited. That makes your brain power go to work. When you channel electricity up into your brain, you become more alert. But if you hold tension in your body, you're constantly channeling energy to your brain, and that creates a very strong stream of continuous thought. If you want to relax your mind, then it's very important that you relax your body. The human mind is in the brain, and relaxing the muscles and the nerves of the torso and the arms and the legs allows us to release the charge of energy that's sent to the brain. This quiets the thoughts. This balances our psyche. So the first thing we do to establish ourselves in a greater state of peace is feel the body. And when you're feeling the body, you may know that your awareness floats around the body a bit. Maybe you notice this muscle here and this organ there. It's all right. Allow your awareness to become more aware of the different parts of your physical vehicle. In the beginning, your awareness will jump around a bit, but in a little bit of time, it'll soon quiet its movement and settle into a greater whole body feeling. To help you establish yourself in this whole body feeling, we can recommend that you notice the movement of your chest. Your body is breathing itself. You do not need to control it. In a relaxed way, feel your body breathe. Feel your chest move. If you focus too strongly on your chest, you'll notice you stop the breathing action. So this is teaching you to relax more as the consciousness. When you concentrate your focus as consciousness, you automatically send more electrical energy to any organ or muscular tissue you're focusing upon. You see, your consciousness is constantly creating. Your consciousness is constantly sending creative power, invisible creative power, into the forms that you're aware of. So if you focus on an organ with strong concentration, then you will naturally awaken more electricity in that organ. Your God consciousness quality creates energy and channels it to anything you focus upon. So when we focus in a relaxed, open way, we charge the entire body, and we don't interrupt the body's natural rhythms, like the breath. So we relax. Feel the whole body. And also notice the chest. When you're feeling your whole body, notice your buttocks sitting in your seat. Notice the feeling of your torso, the movement of your chest. Notice the placement of your hands, You may also notice your face, feeling your lips and your mouth, feeling the placement of your tongue, noticing your eyes, even your forehead, even your brain. We're not against feeling the brain, but we want to encourage balance within the whole nervous system and the whole physical body. So train yourself to be full body present. Train yourself to be aware of your entire body as it exists inside of space. The more you feel your full body, the more all the energy will balance in your body. When your consciousness is focused on any area, your consciousness is channeling creative energy to that area. And this can create an energetic imbalance in a subtle way. If we're constantly in our brain area, we increase the activity of thought and memory and imagination. If we're constantly focused on a particular organ location, such as having tension in a certain organ, then we're also going to stimulate the psychological activity of that organ. Some people who are always trying to hold in their stomach, they notice that they're feeling a sense of anxiety constantly. It's because they're constantly charging these nerves and they're not letting their body relax. So we want you to relax yourself, relax your awareness, feel yourself sitting. Feel your torso existing in the space of your awareness, the space of this universe. Notice the natural rhythm of breath. By practicing this, you're learning how to be present, truly present with yourself. Being present means being aware. Being present with yourself means being aware of your human form. Many human beings are present with thought or half aware, half present with thought. They're drifting off in their thinking, distracted from this moment. Other human beings are very present in their mind when they're doing work at thinking, when they're trying to do something, including meditation or mindfulness. But we want to create a natural state of presence with our entire human being. We want to be present with our human self, not just human thought, not just the feeling of the human doer or the effort-based self. We want to be more than an idea and more than an action. We want to be present with the form of our human being. And so we relax into the open space of awareness. We feel our body sitting. We feel the form and shape of our body. Notice the position of our hands and arms and legs and feet. Notice the feeling of the mouth, the feeling of the eyes. Try to become aware of the whole vehicle as it exists in the space of this moment. Now, when you're able to create this feeling of open awareness present with your body, you will notice that different times, different organs or locations of your body seem to fire with more electricity. When you hear a sound, you feel energy in your ears. If a bright light appears, perhaps in the space of your environment while your eyes are closed, you will notice more energy appearing in your eyeballs, even behind your closed eyelids. If you have a digestive experience, such as gas in your stomach, you will notice a feeling of electrical energy in the stomach muscle as it pushes the gas through itself. Your human body will still be responding to your environment. Your senses will be responding to the world. Your digestive system will be responding to the processing of food. You will still have forms changing inside of your physical body. When there is a stronger electrical charge, it's because that part of your body is being activated through interacting with the present moment. Oftentimes, the organs interact with the environment around them, but sometimes also within them. While you're training yourself to be this open state of awareness, you're not judging what your body is doing. You're also recognizing the difference between you trying to control the body movement and the body moving on its own. When you hear sound, your ears are going to feel more electricity because your ears are processing an experience. Energy came from the world and entered into your field of hearing. The energy was stronger with the sound. Sound has more energy than silence. And when the sound came into your ear and you heard the sound, your ear experienced more energy listening to the sound than the previous moments listening to silence. So energy came from the world into your ear. And you felt it, you noticed it. And if you recognize yourself as the greater state of awareness, you don't identify yourself as this physical response. You don't think about it, you don't judge it, you don't try to stop it, you don't judge yourself as a bad meditator, you just let it come and go. You realize it's just a natural cause and effect experience, and your body handled it. It didn't need your commentary. It didn't need your analysis. You can stay as this silent awareness, perceiving the body existing in space. This is teaching you to trust the body, to trust your life, to trust how naturally things respond to one another. The more you practice this quiet inner state and less reactivity to the natural automatic movements of your body, the more you will notice your body also calms down and your body reacts less to your environment. You see, previously, dear one, when you would judge and analyze and think about and interpret your physical experiences, your soul would add energy to those experiences. Your soul would add energy to the body parts you're observing by focusing on them and talking about them in your thoughts. And your soul would also add energy to your brain and that location of your brain responsible for thinking. So when you were active in analyzing an experience, you were adding energy to the form that had the experience and also the analytical part of your brain that was cooperating in that analysis. But now that you're not analyzing, now that you're staying as the open state of awareness, the organ area and your brain do not receive additional soul energy. Now they stay relaxed. Now they stay balanced. So you, dear one, are witnessing who you are as this eternal creative self, and what happens when you expand your awareness and perceive the whole physical body. You're observing what happens when you allow your body to simply be a natural part of the environment. And you don't have to judge it or control it or analyze it in any way. You can simply be here enjoying the experience. We'll do this with you for a few moments of time. Notice the feeling of your whole body. Notice yourself seated and the sensation on your buttocks and your legs. Notice your torso, your body sitting upright. Notice the position of your hands, the placement of your arms. Notice the movement of your chest while you breathe. Good. Continue in this state of awareness while we speak with you. So what you are observing is that you can be fully present here, in this world, with the form of your body, without creating a judgment, without needing to analyze anything or motivate yourself to do anything or imagine a future or remember a past. You are teaching yourself to be present with life, present with your physical body in your awareness, present with the environment that surrounds your body, and present with the natural interaction between your body and your environment. You're learning that you don't have to constantly be doing things. You're learning that you can relax and empty and release, that you can be present as an open state of awareness, truly embracing what's happening right now, truly loving right now. And when you're very relaxed, dear ones, you will notice when your body has a sensation, your body responds to that sensation. And you didn't have to create it. You didn't have to do anything. Your mind was in non-judgment and non-resistance, so you allowed the experience to flow. Essentially, dear ones, you are learning how to channel your body's natural biological intelligence. Your body responds to sound and color and scents and flavors. Your body responds to sensations in the organs and digestion, sensations upon the skin. And you are here as a natural experience, not passing judgment, not trying to stop or control or create anything. You're feeling yourself as this open consciousness. You're feeling the body in your consciousness. And you're allowing the activities of your body. You're allowing the natural intelligence to flow through your body. You're allowing your body to channel itself. What we've just taught you is the most important part of this practice of learning to maintain peace. You see, dear ones, oftentimes in spirituality, we try to create more activity to create peace. We try to do a practice that controls something in order to obtain silence. We think that stillness is the result of holding our breath or focusing very tightly in our forehead. But we don't realize that as soon as we let go of that practice, the activities return. And even while we're doing the practice, it appears stressful, like we're fighting against something. If we observe the nature of the practice, we realize we're actually not creating stillness. We're not creating less activity. We're actually creating more activity. You see, dear ones, if you want to create something, you must become that thing. That is the best way to do it. In fact, that is the only authentic way to do it. Human beings are still identified as being their physical body and the thought-based self. So they've created techniques and ideas that execute actions from the thought-based self. And you can get temporary results because the thought-based self is a temporary form. But once you release the action of that thought-based self, then the body and the world return back to their normal states. With you, we're trying to change the normal state. We're trying to deepen a state of peace and have it as a natural, effortless experience. To accomplish this, we must learn to live from, to create from, that deeper state of self. So we have to notice the feeling of our consciousness. We must feel the open space of awareness. We must feel the qualities of silence and stillness. We observe ourselves as an empty intelligence, an empty awareness, and an empty creative power that is constantly manifesting this experience. Then we begin to notice the physical body. We let the body be as it is because we know we are not the body. We have a body. We create with the body. But the body is also creating itself. The body breathes itself. It digests its food. It responds naturally to the senses and the environment. We're learning how to develop a healthy relationship of peace and harmony with our body. We're not judging our body, we're not creating conflict with our body, we're not fighting against our body's natural experiences. We're really learning how to live in wisdom with our body. And as we said, this is different than many spiritual practices and many spiritual systems. We're trying to create wisdom. We're trying to live in harmony. And if we do this properly, the body will give itself to us. If we develop a relationship of peace and love with something, it wants to connect with us. It wants to merge with us. It's like in your human relationships. It's like in your relationship with your cats and your dogs. If you create an energy of peace and love, it's very attractive to the forms of life to desire to connect to you. When you are in your soul state and you're being the love and the peace of your soul, automatically the forms of the world are seeking happiness, and so they'll be seeking you. And so your body relaxes into you. Your body releases its stress and its resistance, and your body gives itself to your consciousness. The unity experience of body and consciousness happen in an effortless way because you are being the desirable qualities of stillness and love, of peace and celebration. You're being present as your soul, and your soul is these qualities. Automatically, the body gives itself to you, and the ego activity slows and stops. Automatically, this happens. And we've just explained to you precisely the reason why. Try to understand and try to embrace this knowledge. It's very powerful when it's understood and utilized. So feel your body, be as the open space, and trust that your body is perfectly happy being here. Your body doesn't need to change anything. If you have a itch, scratch it. If you want to move to put pressure on a different part of your buttocks or your legs, then move, adjust yourself. If there's something bothering you right now, then make that change. If there's a loud sound, if light is flashing, just let it happen. This is showing your body you trust its natural expression. And if you allow this, the body calms and quiets itself. This is very different than trying to control and force the body into stillness. You know what happens when you force the body to stay in one place? You get these itches, and they grow really, really, really strong, and you just keep resisting scratching that itch. You hold back scratching that itch, and you notice that you left that place of open, spacious peace while you were obsessing with not scratching the itch. You weren't meditating, you weren't in oneness, you weren't in harmony, you were in resistance to your body's natural desire to scratch its own itchy place. And if you let this itch be scratched, then the body's done, it's relaxed. The nerve sensation that was causing the itch was then released with the scratching motion. The body remedied itself, and you let it happen. And then you just... well, truly, you didn't waste even a moment of time because you were relaxed in the process the whole time the body was moving and scratching its own itch. But if you were obsessed with not moving and not scratching, you were spending valuable moments of time increasing the charge of anxiety in your physical body. And your thoughts may have even stirred as you're analyzing, can I scratch the itch? Should I not scratch the itch? What should I be doing? When you trust the perfection of life, you stay at peace. And your body still interacts, but you're not creating stress. Someone asks you a question, you look, you listen, you respond. But you are empty, open, and at peace. You're channeling while you live, because you're not in the brain fighting with things. You're open and connected, united with things, and trusting the intelligence in the forms. You're trusting life. That's a root chakra quality, which means it allows your nervous system relaxed, and you don't spend all this energy fighting against what is. You allow what is, so your root chakra becomes stable and strong. You maintain this energy because you're not using it in a resistant way, so you build up strength inside your chakras. There's all these benefits to learning how to be at peace with life. So if you want to create a state of peace, this is what we recommend. Practice being this open state of awareness. Practice being present with the forms. And when you don't have to do anything with personal effort, you can just open up and let the body do what it's going to do. And you can learn to expand this experience of being the awareness while your body performs its normal responsibilities. Brushing your teeth, preparing your food, eating your food. You can still be with the body, not distant and checked out in your imagination or half asleep in dreaming thought, but present, fully present here with what is. And allowing your body to move, and allowing your body to prepare your food, and you witness it and you watch it, and there's no commentary in your thought, and there's no resistance in your body. You're still moving, but it's smooth and it's easy, and you're feeling a sense of freedom, peace, and joy while you're in this greater state of expansion, while you're connected as consciousness into the form. So practice creating peace in your life while you're present. This is the most important part. This is the foundation. And as you build this foundation, it'll expand into all the other areas. Now, the only other thing to teach you in this regard, dear one, is to relax back into this state when you notice you stepped out of it. You see, there's really only two steps. First, you cultivate the state you want to be in. And in this teaching of deep peace, right, we want you to practice being the space that is with the body, both within it and around it. We want you to practice being aware of the form and allowing the form to be as it is. This creates the foundation. And then in those moments when you realize you've lost that space, you've been distracted in thought, you had to go become the personal doer and accomplish something, as soon as you notice that you've completed that part of your experience and you desire to return to this still place, then just relax again into that feeling of being space. The feeling of the peace and the stillness that fills this moment. Relax into that experience. Feel yourself opening. Notice the body present inside of that space. Feel yourself as this, and just return. It's that simple, it's that easy, and it's that direct. You don't have to do anything like holding your breath or counting your breath or imagining something or saying a prayer or using a mantra. All of that just stimulates more activity. If you're finding it difficult to relax, then what we recommend is you inhale and feel your whole body expand, because this will charge your nerves with activity. Remember, whenever you willfully create something, you add energy. And when you move your muscles, you add more energy. So focusing on something adds energy, and moving something adds energy. Those are two different ways to increase energy. So when you do both of them, you create a lot of energy in your body. So you're feeling your body and you're breathing your body with your willpower. You inhale, filled up, that charges your nerves. And then you exhale and you relax and you release it. And when you exhale, you don't hold back. It's not a long, slow exhalation. It's an emptying out release. And you can inhale through the nose and exhale through the mouth. So this type of breath releases a lot of stress. It's not a meditative breath. A meditative breath is both in and out through the nose, and they are both balanced and long. Not stressful, but balanced and long. This breath is designed to release stress from the body, to release activity and tension from the physical body. So, if you're having difficulty just resetting and returning to this peaceful, natural, open state of presence with the self, then we recommend doing one or a few more deep breaths. Maybe one does it. Maybe you need two. Sometimes you may need three. But if you do this properly, just these short breaths should be enough to release the buildup of tension from when you were being active in this world, when you were being the doer, when you were engaged in some effort-based, focused concentration. And so, two practices, two simple things to do. First, feel yourself and build that foundational experience. Learn what it's like to be open and present, aware of your whole human body as best as you can. While you're in this state, you're trusting the natural experience. You're not trying to hold on to stillness and resist the body's natural movements because that just charges the nerves and makes it more difficult to relax. So you learn how to really trust, psychologically, trust your body's intelligence. Let your body breathe itself. It's going to do a perfect job. Let your body respond to sights and sounds. And if your body has an itch, let your body scratch it. Your body knows what to do. Build trust. Build trust, because that helps you relax and create this expanded state of peace. The next part, when you've found that you've lost focus, just return. And if you have difficulty immediately returning to this open state, if you find there's too much energy in your nervous system, your thought activity just keeps going, then increase the vibration in your whole nervous system. Feel your whole body inhale. Feel your nerves charging with electricity when you inhale your body. And then relax and empty, and notice the silence that's created with that relaxation. If you still have this energized feeling in your body, this subtle stress in your nervous system, if you still have activities in your mind, then inhale once more. And empty again. If you need to continue this, do it, but don't do it from a place of stress. Don't try to relax your body by doing and doing and doing this practice, because then you're going to get caught in this cycle, this repeating pattern of tensing your body and charging your body with the desire to release your body. And you'll just stay repeating it like a dog chasing its own tail. You see, if you keep charging something, it's not going to relax. So you do it fully, once, maybe twice, three times, rarely, and that should be enough to release it sufficiently. Now, some of you have a lot of charge, constant activity in your brain and body, trauma from your past that's not letting your nervous system relax. As you cultivate this foundation of peace, the foundation will get deeper and deeper, more peaceful and more peaceful. So you practice this, and you trust this. And maybe three breaths relaxes the nervous system a little amount, maybe 20%, for example. That's good. Stay as the peace. Be in awareness. Maybe all you can release is 20% with the breath. But then as you stay as that deeper space, you'll notice the relaxation also deepens. And perhaps you clear out another 20% of stress in your nervous system, and you feel yourself very relaxed, much more than usual. Well, perhaps you still have 60% charge in your nervous system. As you keep practicing day after day, week after week, you're going to notice the same technique takes you lower and lower and lower. You don't need a different technique. Remember, when you focus and do something, you're actually adding a charge. You can be skillful and add a charge that supports the emptying of the charge. So you fill your whole nervous system and then release your whole nervous system. That's helpful. But don't believe if you create more activity by affirmations or prayer or breath control, something like this, that's going to stabilize a natural state of effortless pace. So we want you to learn how to relax and be present, because that's going to take you deeper and deeper. So that's our teaching, that's our practice, that's our recommendation. We hope that it helps you as you apply this in your own life, because with only the application will you experience the validation of the information we've been teaching. To listen to it is not enough. You have to dedicate yourself to application of these words. Use the practices, because then you'll experience the benefits. What you really want is the benefit from all the work you're doing and all the learning you're doing. You want the benefit from everything so that you have more peace and happiness and love in your life. So put these into practice, and you'll find in a very natural, easy way, they bring you to these greater states of happiness. We thank you for listening to us. We wish you the greatest success, the greatest happiness and peace as you apply our teachings. Remember, dear ones, that you're here as creators, and when you create in harmony with the design of life, you reach your desired outcome. It's not enough just to wish it and want for it. You have to, dear one, create it, and that means you as consciousness have to come into form and learn how the form works. The design of life is perfect, absolutely perfect. There's not a single flaw anywhere in God's universe, because God is perfect. God is the all-knowing. God is the all-knowing, so everything has perfection. We as human beings can appreciate that all-knowing mind and that all-perfect state, and we can learn to work with the design of life instead of fighting against it. So embrace these teachings, embrace your life, celebrate the perfection of all that is. We wish you love. We wish you happiness. Namaste.